Hello, and welcome to another edition of the North News. I'm your host, Andrew Gonzalez. At North, we believe in the benefits of participation in co-curricular activities. Recently, student ambassadors spoke to all of the ninth grade students to come to promote the 56 available clubs at our campus and encourage involvement.
My name is Brandon, and I am a senior at North, and I'm involved in a handful of clubs, one being student government. I am the student body president for student government at the school. I was elected last year and was the first junior president, which was a great honor and achievement of mine. But I'm also involved in newspaper, yearbook, the senior council, kindness club, and Italian Honor Society, which is, if any of you guys pursue Italian, it's a great thing to apply to and try to get in. But, we have a handful of many extra great clubs and organizations here at North. And, I really think many of you should get involved because you meet a lot of new people, meet a lot of friends. And I know I've met many friends and I consider them now lifelong friends. So it's great to just be a part of the community and help. And today you're going to hear from a handful of students who are involved in all different sorts of clubs and organizations.
Week of Respect at North is recognized at the beginning of October, and each day has a particular theme. One of the themes was asking students what they were thankful for. So we, the North News, went around and asking people just that.
I'm Daniel Cunningham, and I'm here with
Dr. Lana Cook.
What are you thankful for?
I'm most thankful for my three sons and all of the students at North that I get to work with every day.
So we're asking people around the school, what are you thankful for? So the question is, what are you thankful for?
Of course I'm thankful for you, Janelle, our best javelin thrower at the school. I'm very thankful for my family, of course.
Okay, so we're asking people around the school what are they thankful for? So the question is, what are you thankful for?
I mean, I'm thankful for a lot of things, but I think what I'm thankful for the most is my family, my two daughters and my wife. Really above all else, but I'm also thankful for my job, for being here at High School North, getting a chance to work with you guys.
Hi, I'm Mr. Cullen, principal of High School North.
What are you thankful for, Mr. Cullen?
I'm thankful for my fantastic job in this amazing learning community and, of course, for my family and friends.
Hi, I'm Coach Rose. I'm the strength and conditioning coach here at Middletown North High School. I'm thankful for the opportunity change lives every day, and the kids that I work with are doing a tremendous job, so I'm thankful for them and their hard work.
I'm here with
Mr. Glesman.
Okay, so the question is, what are you thankful for?
I'm thankful, one, for you, Janelle, just an awesome student overall. I'm thankful for my freshman world history students. I'm thankful for my one sophomore US1, and I'm thankful that I get to coach the girls flag football team because they're awesome.
And I'm here with
Mr. Russ.
What are you thankful for?
I'm thankful for my family, thankful for having a job that I love to go to every day.
But what are you thankful for, Madame Jones?
I'm thankful for my family, my sons, my job, my French students. Bonjour.
What are you thankful for?
Thankful for my life, my family, my friends, and this guy right here.
I'd say that I'm grateful for my friends and my family.
I'm grateful for having really good academics and my friends and my family.
I'm grateful for all the successes I've been able to make with all my friends.
My name is William Messiah, and I'm very thankful for this school and everything I can learn in my family and friends.
I'm thankful for my family and my friends.
I'm thankful for the friends and family.
I'm thankful for my family.
Family and friends and food.
What are you thankful for, Noah?
I'm thankful for my parents.
What are you thankful for?
I'm thankful for school. Education.
What are you thankful for?
I'm thankful for school and having classes with the rest of
you. Nate, it's Respect Week. What's one thing you're thankful for?
Thank you. I'm thankful for the school.
So what's one thing you're thankful for?
I'm thankful for the great community here at North.
What are you thankful for?
I'm thankful for my mom.
That's valid. And it is Respect Week here at Middletown North. And what's one thing you're thankful for?
My mom.
I was going to say that. I'm thankful for Jersey.
Oh, yeah. There you go. That's so sweet.
Thank you.
What does the Week of Respect mean to you?
Being more patient with my students that are challenging
and making sure that everybody feels comfortable in my classroom and my space.
What does the Week of Respect mean to you?
The Week of Respect, just trying to reinforce, like, let's do the right thing, you know, for each other, and, you know, let's be mindful of each other and everybody else, what they got going on in their life, and be respectful of that, whether it's good, bad, or indifferent. Just, you know, just try and be mindful of those around us.
What does the Week of Respect mean to you?
I think it's a great thing, and I believe it's just to try your hardest to be respectful to everybody around you.
The Week of Respect means showing love to people or, like, strangers you don't know, just to be respectful.
One advanced class that created the short film Krampus on Campus had a big accomplishment. The end of last school year, the short film was accepted to the film festival Dances with Films in LA, California, and the film screened at the Chinese Theater. They recently screened in Atlantic City and have one more upcoming screening in Boston. North recently had some very special guests, including the mayor of Middletown and the president of the Board of Education, for the Sustainable Jersey Ribbon Cutting Ceremony to recognize the students' work over the past few years. The ceremony took place on October 10th in the Outdoor Learning Lab. Dr. Cartier made an appearance for her efforts in creating the outdoor learning environment. Thank you to everyone who joined us at the North event. And that's it for the first edition of the North News. Have a wonderful day, and we'll see you soon.